Okay, so before we get into solving more linear equations, one of the things we need to discuss is solving systems of equations. And this is a topic we are going to discuss all semester, and we're just going to look at it in different ways. This is discussed in sections 6.1, 6.2, and 6.3 of your book. Solving a systems of equations is the same as finding the point of intersection, the break-even point, the equilibrium point as well. Okay, so if you see any of these three words or combinations, they are talking about the same thing. Now, you have learned this in algebra 1, and then you got it a little tougher in algebra 2. So, to solve a system, you must use one of three, or sometimes all three methods. Your first method is elimination. Okay. So for elimination, 99% of the time with elimination, you do with just two equations. Okay. And what you're going to do is you're going to find the LCD or LCM, the least common denominator, least common multiple. Let's call it least common multiple, not LCD. Least common multiple of the coefficient for the variable you want to get rid of. Okay. Then you are going to get, then you're going to multiply both equations to have that LCM. Okay. So you're going to convert it to have that LCM value for that variable. But one equation will be opposite signs. Okay. Then you add the two equations together. Solve, then plug your solution back into one of the original equations, and then you will have your answer, and then your solution will be a point. Okay? Elimination is one of the tougher methods, and you only use it when you have two equations. Okay? You will rarely see me do elimination in these. If you want to use elimination, go on ahead and do it. I don't mind. And if you need help with the elimination method, please speak up and ask. I will show it in one of the examples, but as I said, I typically don't use elimination. Method two, substitution. This method you will use countless number of times. Okay? You are going to solve one equation for a variable, and it doesn't matter what variable, and if you don't believe me as we go through these examples, solve it different than me and see if you don't get the same answer. Then you're going to substitute. You're going to plug what you got into the other equations. Solve for the variable. And then plug your solution into the first equation you solved for. Okay. Now, what's fun about substitution is you can do this with two or more equations. Okay. So you could have, say, 10 equations with 10 variables, and you are going to do substitution about a dozen times to get it to work. Okay. And then the last one, and you will see this method used a lot as well, the set equal method. This one only works with two equations. You're going to solve both equations for one variable. Okay. Then you're going to set them equal. And solve. And then plug your solution in to get the answer. Okay. And for even for this previous one, for the substitution method, you will get your final answer. Will be a point. And then the same thing here. Okay. And as I said, practice these methods. Find the one or ones that work for you. As I said, depending on the problem, you may use all three methods in one problem to solve. But that's getting into more of the more complex and higher level problems. What I have found a lot of students do is the substitution or the set equal. I've also seen a few, and it's not as many, but I have seen a couple students that go by elimination because that's what they feel most comfortable with. And for me, I don't care which one you use. But what I am going to say, make sure you know how to do substitution, because we are going to use substitution a lot in this class. So make sure you understand this method. Okay, so now let's take these notes and put it to actual applicational use. Find the point of intersection, answers in exact form. If there is no solution or infinite solutions, explain why. So starting with the first problem, we are told we have 7x minus 12y is equal to 20, and 14x minus 12y equal 20. Okay. With this, as I said, choose any method you want to use. With this one, I'm going to show by all three. You don't have to do all three methods. Choose the method you want. Okay. As I said, if you don't feel that all three will work, solve it by one of the other methods and see if it does. Okay? So, let's first do this by elimination. Okay? So remember, elimination method, when we look back at our notes, we want to find the least common multiple, or LCD, for one of the variables' coefficients. Okay? Well, and we want it to have opposite signs. Well, for here, we see that our y has the exact same coefficient, but the signs are the same. So what that means we need to do is multiply either this top equation or bottom equation by negative 1. We need to multiply one of the equations by negative 1. And this will get us to where we can use our elimination method. No, it does not matter which one we do. And if you don't believe me, try it with the other and see what happens. Well, let's just multiply this top one by negative 1. So that gives us negative 7x plus 12y equals negative 20. And then we have 14x minus 12y equal 20. All right, so here, now, what we do, as the next step says, is it says to add them. So negative 7 plus 14 is 7x. Those cancel, equals 0, divide by 7. X is 0. Now, we take this 0 and plug it back into either the second or the first equation. It does not matter, because with this, remember, we're finding the point of intersection. We're finding where these cross. So 7 times 0 minus 12y equal 20. So y is equal to negative 20 over 12, which is reducible by 4, so negative 5/3. Okay, and so with that, our point of intersection is 0 and negative 5/3. Boom. That one was not that hard for elimination. They can get tougher with elimination. Okay, so let's go with this. Now, let's do the same equation by substitution. Okay. So we copy this over. And as I said, you do not have to use all three methods to solve this. You only have to choose one. Okay. All right. So remember, for substitution, you choose one equation, solve for that variable, and then plug it into the next one. So let's solve this one for x. All right. So we add our 12y and divide by 7. So x equals 20 plus 12y, and then we divide by 7. And now we plug this into our x. So that gives us 14 times 20 plus 12y over 7 minus 12y equal 20. All right, and now we solve for y. Well, 7 and 14, so this becomes, now we distribute that 2, because 14 is divisible by 7, so we got 40 plus 24y minus 12y, and that should be a y, is equal to 20. All right, subtract your 40 from both sides, and so we get 12y is equal to negative 20, and then we get negative 20 over 12, which is negative 5/3. Now, we take this and plug it back into here. You could plug it back into either one of these, but if we plug it here, it's already solved for x for us. So x equals 20 plus 12 times negative 5/3 all over 7. So 20, all right, so 3 will go into 12 4 times, times negative 5 is negative 20. So this is minus 20, sorry, all over 7, which is 0. So x equals 0. So the point of intersection is 0 and negative 5/3. So we see it's already working for both methods. Now we have to do, or check our last method, which is the set equal. So set equal. Ooh. So with this one, remember we solved both equations for one variable. Set them equal and solve. Well, we already know from the previous one, x equals 20 plus 12y over 7. So that means for the second one, x will equal 20 plus 12y over 14. Well, all of these are divisible by 2, so this is 10 plus 6y over 7. All right. So now we set both equations equal. So 20 plus 12y over 7 is equal 10 plus 6y over 7. All right. So remember from your algebra classes, you can cross multiply or multiply everything by 7 and your 7s will cancel. So we got 140 plus 84y is 70 plus 42y. All right. Oops. So subtract the 42y, subtract the 140. So you're left with 42y equal negative 70. Y is negative 70 over 42. Alright, divide by 7 and that's negative 10 over 6. Divide by 2 and that's negative 5/3. And now you plug this into either here or here. Well, we know if we plug that back up here, we still get our 0. So our point of intersection is 0 and negative 5/3. Okay, so with this, you have to, as I said, decide which method you want to use. As I said, with elimination and set equal, you can only do that with two equations. Whereas if you have multiple equations, you will want to possibly use your substitution. Or you can use, as we'll show a little later in some of these, you may do a set equal on both, on two of them, and then solve and do a substitution. Okay? So, moving into the next example. So, let's say I gave you 12x minus 5y equal 10. 24x minus 10y equal 20. Okay? So, with this one, you can do whatever method you want. Okay? So for this one, I'm going to multiply this by negative 2, because I know 2 times 12 is 24, and 2 times 5 is 10. So this gives us negative 24x plus 10y is equal to negative 20. Alright, so here, those cancel, you're left with 0 equals negative 20. Well, looky here, 0 equal negative 20. Well, that here is not possible. So for here, this is no solution. The reason for this, when you solve these for y, what you're going to see here is these are parallel lines. Okay, so when you solve this here, you're going to get y is equal to it would be 12/5 x minus 2. And then for this one, y would equal still your 12/5 x minus 2. Oh, wait, no. Sorry. Sorry about that. That should not be. This should be 0. Sorry, 20 minus 20 is 0. So ignore all that. So 24 minus 24 cancels. 10 minus negative 10 plus 10 cancel. And 20 minus 20 is 0. This here, 0 does equal 0. This is infinite solutions or all reals. Because, as shown here, we're getting the same line. So we have the same line. So when you get a number equal the same number, it is all real solutions. Now, there are times when you do get your answers. So just as a side example, let's say you've done your elimination method and you get, say, 7 equal 5. Well, in that case, that right there is no solution, which means the lines do not intersect. Okay, and this typically happens when you have parallel, or this will happen when you have parallel lines. Okay, so when the lines are parallel to each other, you have no solution because they will not intersect. Okay, so if by your elimination or substitution or your set equal methods, if you get to a number equal another number and those numbers are not the same, it is no solution because the lines are parallel. Okay, so moving forward, here's where it starts to get a little fun and interesting. Let's say you have 5x plus 7y minus z equal 3, negative 3x minus 6y plus z equal 5, 2x plus 7y equal 20. And you want to find the point of intersection. Okay, so we're still finding that point of intersection, but our answer is going to be x comma y comma z. Okay, so with here, you have to diagnose and figure out what's going to be the easiest way of solving this. Okay, well, initially you're probably going, what in the world is this? Well, once you get through that, and it takes practice and time to recognize, but if we look at these first two equations here, we can do elimination because we can cancel those z's. Okay, so let's do that. So if we combine those two, bring it down here. So 5x minus 3x is 2x. 7 minus 6y is 1y. Negative z plus z is 0. Equal 8. And then bring down 2x plus 7y equal 20. Okay. Now, from here, you've got multiple ways. You can do your set equal, your elimination, or substitution. Here you can do elimination again by multiplying the top by negative 1. Okay. So we get negative 2x minus y equal negative 8. So 7y minus y is 6y, because 2x minus 2x is nothing. 20 minus 8 is 12, and y equals 2. All right, now, you need to plug this in to get your rest of your solutions. Well, let's take this and plug it right there, because here we're just missing x, or we can find our x. So we've got 2x plus 7 times 2 equal 20. So 2x plus 14 equal 20. 2x equals 6 by subtracting 14. And then divided by 2 is 3. And now, let's go with burgundy. Now you take the 3 and the 2, and you go back up to either here or here. And if you don't believe me, you can plug it into both of them and make sure your z comes out the same. So let's do 5 times 3 plus 7 times 2 minus z equal 3. So you get 15 plus 14 minus z equal 3. 29 minus z equal 3. Negative z equal negative 26. And then divide by negative 1. And now what you can do to check to make sure all three of these answers work is plug in your 2, 3, and 26 into this other equation and make sure you get 5, which you will. So our point of intersection is 3, 2, and 26. Okay, so on to the hardest, and they get just more difficult from here. We have x plus y plus z is equal to negative 8, 2x minus 7y minus 3z is 20, negative 5x plus 10y minus 20 equals negative 50. So once you get through the, oh crud, this is insane look, take and think back to the setup for elimination, substitution, and set equals. We can't do elimination because we only need 2 equations, and the same thing for set equal. So that tells us we need to use substitution. Okay? And what I'm going to do is I'm going to label this as equation A, equation B, and equation C, and write out the steps. So let's solve equation A for x. Now, does it matter which way you do this? No, it does not. You definitely can't use elimination or substitution, so that does matter. But it doesn't matter which equation you solve and for what variable. If you don't believe me, which is good, I want you to try it the other way and see what happens. So that gives us x equal negative 8 minus y minus z. Now, our next step is to plug this in, as we plug this into B and C. So that means we get 2 times negative 8 minus y minus z minus 7y minus 3z is equal to 20. Okay. So negative 16 minus 2y minus 2z minus 7y minus 3z is equal to 20. Now, combine your like terms. So add the 16 to both sides. And then, so negative 2y and negative 7y will give us negative 9y. Negative 2z minus 3z is negative 5z equal 36. So this is the new B. Now we repeat for C. So negative 5 times negative 8 minus y minus z plus 10y minus 20z equal negative 50. So that is 40 plus 5y plus 5z plus 10y minus 20z equals negative 50, negative 150, which when we add the 40 over and then combine, so 5y and 10y is 15y, 5z minus 20z is negative 15z, and then 40 minus 50 is negative 10, which is our new C. Okay, there was a minor error. that should have been negative 90 when we subtract 40. Okay? And now, with this, if we look at B and C, from here you can do elimination, you could do set equal, or you could do substitution. It is your choice. For me, let's go by elimination. Let's multiply B by negative 3. All right, and that gives us 27y plus 15z equals negative 108. And so we have 15y minus 15z is equal to negative 90. All right. So that is 42y equals negative 198. Divide by 42, so negative 198 over 42. All right, this is reducible by 2. So 198 divided by 2 is 99 over 21. And then this is reducible by 3, so that's negative 33 over 7. Okay, now that we have y, we can plug this back into either B or C to solve for z. And neither one looks very nice, but let's go with B. So let's plug the y equal negative 33 over 7 into B, which will give us, alright, so B was negative 9y, so negative 9 times negative 33 over 7 minus 5z equal 36. Alright, so 33 times 9 is 297. 297 over 7 minus 5z equal 36. All right, and then we solve for z. So let's times everything by 7. So that gives us 297 minus 35z equal 36 times 7 is 252. Alright, subtract the 297. Subtract 297. Get negative 45. And then divide by negative 35. You get positive 45 over 35, which is 9/7. Now you plug y equal negative 33 over 7, z equal to 9 over 7 into A and solve for x. And so, negative 8 minus y minus z. So x equals negative 8 minus your y, so minus negative 33 over 7, minus 9/7. So that gives us negative 8 plus 33 over 7 minus 9 over 7. So multiply 8 by 7, so that's negative 56 plus 33 minus 9 over 7. So we have negative 56 plus 33 minus 9 is negative 32/7. And so our point of intersection, not equals, is negative 32 over 7, negative 33 over 7, and 9/7. Now, with the other videos I'm going to show, with what your homework will show, they may show doing substitution for these all the way through. And that is fine. And there's nothing wrong with it. For some of y'all that are the 4-year business majors, you will take, I believe it's Math 170 here at USCL, and the professor that teaches that's how he teaches it, is by doing backward substitution. But this is solving systems of equations. I know with this video there's not many of the substitution, elimination, and set equal to. The reason being, in the next video, when we get into solving equations more, we're going to do more points of intersection, so we're not done with this topic.